What's going on, dudes, boys and girls, friends and viewers, people who I do know and those I still do not. My name is Kolosalus, welcome back to another Heroes of the Storm video. Today we'll be taking a look at Valeera Sanguinar, the newly added assassin into the Nexus. Well, not newly, she's been out for like 2 weeks. She's an assassin from Warcraft universe, of course. Again, that shenanigans of different assassins. Again, what I want to say is that as you get better at the game, you stop caring about the universe and the label the developers have slapped on the character. You more care about how the actual character plays, what she's good at, and how to counter that character. Well, Valeera is countered by reveals, and I'll actually show you how that works. But what she's labeled at is an assassin, but most importantly, as a carry shutdown. She's supposed to shut down the Li Ming, the tracer, the Varian. She's supposed to shut them down, not basically make them unable to cast their abilities and basically die straight after. This doesn't happen most of the time, and she's actually supposed to get a buff in the next patch. But regardless, we're gonna go into the game, show you guys what she's all about, and hopefully kind of give you guys a very, very good overview of how to play her and how to succeed with her. Here we go. All right, boys and girls, find yourselves on the Garden of Terror map. Why am I unlocked? There we go. Why was my camera moving along with me? It's like, it's not what you want to do. Right, on level 1, let's see how many reveals they have. They have no reveals, no reveals, no reveals. This guy doesn't get a reveal, right? I don't think he gets a scouting drone. No reveals, no reveals. Alright. We're gonna go for my favorite trait build. Shamblerus shall rise. Yes. Alright, so Valeera, her Q ability is called Sinister Strike, very similar to the Sweeping Strike from Illidan. It kind of pushes her forward, and if she hits an enemy, she stops immediately and also, of course, deals damage. Oh, she's dead as fuck! I don't want to say anything, but she was almost dead. Anyway, yeah. It's going to deal damage, basically stop you, deal damage, and then make you stop immediately. And generate you a combo point. So, again, let's get this right this time, okay? So, it's going to make you stop. Deal damage, and also generate you a combo point. Combo point is something you can spend afterwards, but we're gonna talk about that in a second. There we go, there's the blob. W ability is called Blade Flurry. It's very similar to how Cleave works for the Zerato. It's going to just deal some damage in the area, and also generate combo point for every hero that you hit with it. Oh baby, no! Oh, she really got me with that. Okay, that's fine. We'll just be able to get away with this Sinister Strike. I'm gonna go back for a second. And our E ability allows us to spend our combo points to deal either a very light amount of damage, medium amount of damage, and very bursty amount of damage with three, depending on the level of your combo points. This Eviscerate kind of rewards you for having the most combo points and then spending them. The enemy Li Ming is so out of position. I do like that. Oh, good. Fucking Dahaka. God damn it, Dahaka. I do really want to kill your Li Ming Gizzle. Oh, look at that. Look at that gang squad. Fine by me. Whoop, 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 whoop. Oh, she's dead as fuck, boys. Nice, 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 nice. We're going to go for initiative. Right. To invade, bitch. That's exactly what it is, man. Exactly what it is. I wish you'd be going for some objectives now, I think. The enemy, the Haka. Oh. Ooh, so close. Whoop. I'm fine. I got Sinister Strike, and I got everything. The enemy team doesn't have Valeera, so we are safe to do whatever we fucking please. This is mostly gonna be a bloodbath just because we have two stealthies and a murky. So it's mostly gonna be just team fighting in the middle, just not really giving a shit about anything. A kind of match today. But regardless, we're gonna try to win anyway. So she also has her trait. Her trait is called Vanish, which basically, there you go. It puts me into this like this invis mode where I also actually gain some movement speed, and I gain a set of new abilities. I can basically those are kind of the engage abilities. We need help, baby. We need you to rotate, heal. And the set of new abilities basically allows me to either deal a lot of damage, which I did right there. There we go, nice dodge. Easy dodgy. A lot of damage, or W, which actually allows me to stun the target, which is exactly what I do most of the time. Like right there. And deal a very, very light damage. So but again, your Q does burst damage, but doesn't do anything else. Your W will stun the target and deal a very, very light amount of damage. And your E will silence the target for 2 seconds. By the way, the stun is 1.5 times, which is pretty crazy. I think if she does get picked in competitive, she is going to be like... she's going to a little bit like a stun ball. She's going to be only used for the stun as a setup. But yeah. We're going to try to actually contest this. We should be at least trying to contest this. Come back to me. I want to show you my loving. You. easy kills right here. The enemy team just getting picked apart by the double stealthy composition. I'm not sure why Zeratul was just kind of just chilling in like low health, low mana, like all of the time. This guy, I will have to be careful of the gorge, but it'll be fine. Yeah. So. Again, they tried to give her like a lot of different kind of engages, you know, they give her a silence, a stun, a Q. Close, but I dodged it, boy. I dodged it, Stitches. It's not gonna be that easy with me, I'm not that easy. But her stun is just so strong that I believe that it's gonna be mostly be down to your stun, pretty much. Oh, the hacker coming in. Whoop! I think I'm dead, actually. Maybe not. No, I'm not dead. I'm fine. I'm just gonna be here. Get the full health. Yeah. So again, just the stun proves to be so long and just so impactful that I think using the other two actually puts you at a disadvantage compared to, like, let's say the enemy team also has a Valeera in a quick match scenario. If she uses the stuns and you don't, your team is gonna be at the biggest disadvantage because stuns make people stay still. I think the stun should be nerfed. And the silence is very, very strong as it is, but there we go. That's all Gucci. Yeah. So they kind of failed in that scenario. They kind of failed in, you know, in making her other engages very, very viable. This guy should be dead. I actually wasted one. Oh, I missed my Q. Oh, god damn it. That was my fault. Oh, I just messed up my Q. I messed up my Q and it didn't give me a combo point. God damn it. Right, anyway. So what I was going to do is tell you guys about his builds. Not his, her. Her talent builds. I'm going to go for Smoke Bomb Deliver Range. I think it's just the best in the tier. Trying to kind of harass the Stitches a little bit here. Ooh, I see that. I see that Li Ming right behind them, though. That Li Ming look really tasty. Real tasty. What was that? What? I think I can kill him. There we go. Oh, no. Oh, no. Close, way too close, but we're fine. Right, let's actually go back here. We are very, very low. Anyway, level 1, we did go for the subtlety, which Because she uses energy, she only has 100 of it, and she uses a lot of energy on her abilities. I want to somehow sustain that energy. And that's what I do with my level 1 talent. After remaining vanish for 4 seconds, for at least 4 seconds, using any of your abilities from the actual vanish, will allow you to also regenerate additional 10, because you already regen 10 energy per second, it will allow you to regen 10 additional 10 10 energy per second. We are closing up on this. Wow, the burst damage is crazy here. Oh, babe. Whoop. That's how I take care of my region, my kind of energy region. I'm not gonna use my vanish here because I do want to, in case it comes to it, I do want to disengage at some point. And Haka's coming with his vengeance. I'm gonna go into this right now. It looks like our Rexar is under a little bit of pressure, so I'm gonna come in here, try to... Oh, I do get silenced by the enemy, the Haka here. I might be taken down. No, I'll be fine. I'll be okay. So that actually saved the Li Ming, but it still didn't secure them any kills. So it was kind of bad for them. Oh, no. So at level 4 we did go for initiative, which allows you to gain 2 combo points when you use any of your abilities from vanish. Which is very good, right? Because what you can do is you can open up with any of your vanish abilities and then follow up with just almost any ability. Like, you know, basically with any ability, and that's going to be your full combo right there. Which obviously, you know, kind of opens up a lot of options in your kit, right? Like, you're not there forced to basically use every single one of your abilities. I'm going to go in here, stun him just so we keep him in place, and then finish him with our eviscerate, with our finisher kind of ability, which uses the combo points. Yeah, so it opens up a lot of the combos, right? You can basically open up with a stun, follow up with the W, and then finish with the growth, and then use your Q to kind of close the gap between you and the enemy. I'm gonna go behind the enemy team here. We're gonna go for elusiveness on level 13. I'm on my way here. We can do something here. We can definitely do something here. There we go. The actual eviscerate will just finish up the enemy, the Haka, right there. We can come in the middle of this lane, use our blade flutter here. Level 7, we did go for the Fatal Finesse. Fatal Finesse allows you... Very good silence here. No, that was my bad. Fatal Finesse allows you to increase your damage of your W, of the area damage, and when you hit an enemy hero. You have to hit 20. Do you actually get it as you hit people? Yes, you will just kind of gradually get better, and then you will also be reducing its cost after you actually finish the quest, which is awesome, very, very good for just kind of staying high on energy, but also dealing the most damage possible. And on level 10, we did go for smoke bomb. Smoke bomb allows you to create a smoke bomb. While in the smoke, Valeera is unrevealable. This lasts for 5 seconds. And you can pass through other units. You can also use your abilities, the damage she takes while she's in the smoke bomb, you know, from any AoE damage. She's also reduced by 25%, which is pretty goddamn strong. And also while she's in that, her stealth is not going to be... Oh god. Oh god, I just used it there to get away. I think I got away just because of that. I'm gonna be straight away. Level 16. What do I want to go for? Level 16. Let's go for this. I don't think there's any other good ones here. Maybe Seal Fate is good. Maybe. But I have to eviscerate very, very quickly. Yeah, I don't think it's good. Just because you already gained 2 points with your initiative, this point... is just going to be wasted. So I think Seal of Fate is mostly it could be picked for damage, right? But I do believe that you will lose damage actually with this. The enemy team kind of giving a chase to our friendly team. Our Li Ming getting saved by our Zeratul right here. The enemy Samurai kind of out of position, but he looks like he's going to be just fine. I do want to go for this Li Ming Gizzle. You can see how much damage we're able to do, and we're pretty much gonna get away like it's nobody's business. And boom, they can't reveal me anymore. Like, Samurai has no way of revealing me besides Blade Storm, which is 100 something second cooldown, which is fucking nuts. We're gonna be straight away. We won the team fight for the friendly team. Is gonna be, we're gonna leave them in the 4v4 scenario. Looks like we are still getting kind of raped right there, so I'm gonna just make my way straight there. But you can see I took out the enemy caddy. I had to be almost straight after. I mean, if we were still in the fight, we would have been fine. Looks like the enemy team is still doing it though. They're still living the dream. I do want to go for this Tychus. He's another person I'm really, really, really interested in. Basically taking him out. Maybe I'm on the way to you. Looks like Tychus is there trying to take out our Murky. He's gonna pay for it. He's gonna pay for it with his life. He split from the friend from his friendlies. And boom, 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 boy, I see you. That's the real one. That's the real one. That's the real one. Real one. And he's dead. Ah, so beautiful. So beautiful. She's actually very good against Samurai, I think. Her Blade Flurry gives her, like, basically 3 combo points straight away when she Blade Flurries all of the, I don't want to get hit by her skill hook by doing that. Oh god, I got revealed. I still want to go for that Li Ming though. I still want to go for that Li Ming. Okay, he uses Slam right there, so you're going to have no reveals for a little bit. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god, no! Oh. Goodness gracious me. What? Oh no! Oh no! No! Run! I think I'm fine! I think I'm fine! I have no health at all right now. It's just back. Let's just back here. Oh no! She's gonna get recessed.
My egg!
Run, babe!
No.
No, I think you're fine. Okay, I'm just gonna be right there. Looks like they're not chasing. Again, I do not claim to be the best value player in the world. I've spent a little bit of time with her, but I'm just here, guys, to give you guys, you know, a little bit of a maybe different perspective than you had when you played there, and to give you a little bit of insight what I've been hearing from the pros as well. Yes, I was level 10, level 13 will give us 20% movement speed rather than 10 on our trait. So now we're gonna be moving pretty much just under the mount speed. Enemy Li Ming is split from her friendly team, which is, I guess, what I want to do right now. Let's see, they might be doing this camp. Oh, they are. Fuck you, Tychus! Oh, crap moly. Look at the damage. Oh. I was going to kill him, but then the defending team did not collapse. Like, this was just in such an easy interrupt. Only me and my girlfriend went for it. And it was such an easy just interrupt. Such an easy assassinate right there. I don't know. I was waiting for my vanish as well, which was a mistake. I should have just straight up went for him and just killed him. It was my mistake. I should have just straight up. I was waiting for my vanish to stun him, but then that actually made me wait for a split second, which was terrible. And it was a mistake on my part as well. So yeah, 13 minute go for additional 10% additional movement speed. Expose armor, eviscerating an enemy with 3 combo points, which obviously is easier if you have the initiative. Will lower their armor. Basically, they will take 25% increased damage for 2 seconds, and then also a cold blood. Activate to increase the damage of Valeera's next adversary by 100%. With 3 stacks of combo points, we attack for 658 damage right now. So it's gonna be like 1,300 damage, pretty much like that. And I want to show you how much damage this is. Is this the real one? Maybe is that real one? It is. Oh, it wasn't. God damn it. I just wasted it then. Did he go for the... No, he didn't go for the taunt. So why... How the fuck they have so much health? I don't know. We are going to have to wait to show you guys the actual combo now with the cold blood. Cold blood is fucking nuts. It's crazy how good it is. I should be looking for a pickoff. I should not be here with the team. I should be looking for a pick. But looks like the enemy team is doing the smart thing right now. Oh, what is this Ceratul doing? I don't get it though. It's weird. I was going to go for that Tychus, that's why I activated my cold blood. I was actually staying quiet right there, just just that Q just revealed me. It was so maybe your egg is in trouble. We could kill that Haka. I mean, if me and Ceratul go for him, we could just definitely wreck him right here because he's split from the team. Look at the damage. Did you guys see the amount of damage that I dealt? That's fine. I mean, I can still body block you. I mean, you can stun me, but it's not gonna do you any good. So we do pick off the enemy, kind of showing off how strong she can really be when the enemy team is split. But when they're really together and the friendly team is kind of on top of the support, peeling and everything, it's gonna be really hard for her to do anything, just because she doesn't bring anything to a team fight. That's her main issue right now. She doesn't bring anything to a team fight. On my way. And just delete it like that. That's a weird one right there. I'm gonna wait for him. I think I can delete him pretty nicely with my actually it should be WWE that I use. He's gonna go in on this guy. This is the real one. Okay, that's fine. I do have my smoke bomb to disengage. Guys. Okay, I'm fine. I'll be fine. It didn't go as planned just because he used a slam to reveal me. And that's her main reason why she's weak right now. She's weak because any kind of reveal shuts down her main ability, which is her stun. And the other thing is, of course, she doesn't bring anything to a team fight. She doesn't support her team in any way to actually win a team fight or anything like that. I'm closing up on this Dahaka. Like, he will be using his reveal, so I will just linger around for a little bit around him. I need you guys. She can 1v1 almost anybody, I think, in the game. I mean, the Haka is a pretty good 1v1 hero, right? Looks like our Li Ming will be taking out the enemy Samuro. I think my baby died in the process, though. Enemy Li Ming is right there. She's just kind of destroying our structures for no apparent reason. I will go into my my this form. I don't know what this Li Ming is doing. Did she go glass cannon? Because I blew her up like she was nothing. She went glass cannon, guys. She went glass cannon against fucking two stealthies and a Li Ming. What am I watching with no... I guess she has two tanks, but she doesn't have a support. What am I playing? What is it? What's this game I'm playing right now? Baby, can you push a lane a little bit? Like, maybe do something? Let's do this. Yeah, baby, go core, I agree. We're gonna do the objective though. My damage will be kind of off the roof with a single combo. I mean, it's not gonna be a huge like sustained damage kind of combo, but it's definitely gonna be pretty strong. as you know, as I did go for the Fatal Finesse, and I do have all the other abilities which kind of increase my damage, like the Cold Blood. It's just crazy damage. I can pretty much blow up, you know, even the tankiest of tanks right now. Not blow in a single combo, but kind of do a lot of damage. And looks like Zeratul is kind of dancing around this the hack a little bit here. I think he should be able to do a lot of him. I mean, he's gonna get stunned. He might get also silenced like that. Don't let him go, Zeratul. Okay, there's a stun. They got him. Okay, that's good. The enemy team is going for a core rush, I do believe. I don't know. Is this a core rush? Okay, that's fine. So, Li Ming is back at it again in the top lane. we could finish. I mean, this is an easy finish right here. Oh god, I didn't see them reveal me. And this tag is, I think he's just given up right now. 1,000, almost 600 damage right there. I'm gonna kill, actually, it's like Zeratul. Let's see how Zeratul does against that Li Ming. Wow, she got blown the fuck up. Holy moly. Yeah, maybe we can just finish the game here. Honestly, most of the time, the games will not go as butter smooth as this one goes. But I'm not complaining. I'm not complaining, you know what I mean? That's the real one. No, this one's right there. Yeah. Thank you, babe. Alright, can we finish the game or something? Oh, them godlocks are coming! And this is gonna be a good game, boys and girls. Oh god, I got eaten. What the fuck? And it's gonna be good game. Yeah, so it kind of shows off her playstyle, like, and I actually explained, it didn't show off her weaknesses too much, that's why I explained them. Why are we in the belly still? Zeratul, coming in with the MVP. I'm not sure what he was doing most of the time, though some of those VPs were very questionable, but yeah, it was good, game overall. You're there, baby. So, let me go over the build again very, very quickly because I already explained most of the... I'll kind of explain the idea behind the build here. So the idea behind the build is that the enemy team doesn't have reveals, so you can get the most value out of your trait. That's a lot of XP. Almost level 8 right there. Oh, God. Oh, yeah, because this is the first win of the day. Yeah, I keep losing every single time. Feels bad, man. Anyway, so the idea behind this build is that the enemy team will not have a way to reveal you. And if they don't, you will get a lot of... Of course, value from a trait, which is exactly, I just want to go for that. I want to kind of extend that even more. So additional regeneration here. Basically, after 1 second, you can just use a shit ton of your abilities. You know what I mean? Especially if you stay on your vanish for 4 seconds, of course. Level 4, we go for initiative. Again, just giving you a lot more flexibility in your engages, right? So you engage with your W, but then the flexibility comes where you can actually either close the gap to somebody else, maybe use the eviscerate, or let's say you can actually just go WWE, and then you can actually use your Q just to close the gaps when the enemy team, when the enemy person who you're trying to shut down is getting away. It just gives you a lot more flexibility when it comes to killing people. At level 7, Final Finesse, I think, is the best choice, especially against someone like a Samurai. He gives you a lot of stacks, plus also you just kind of increase the damage, plus then also reduce the actual energy you use for your W, which is good. Level 10, you do go for Smoke Bomb. Cloak of Shadows is good. So, for example, I think it's good against someone like let's say a Pyroblast, because this will reduce the ability damage that you take for the next second, and also makes you unstoppable. So the Butcher, when he charges you and you pop this, he's still gonna hit you, but it's not gonna be as big of an issue as it would without this. I do believe Smoke Bomb is still the better choice in almost any scenario, just because it just grants you crazy just crazy utility. You can still you can stay in that smoke for a little bit, maybe deal some harass damage because you won't be revealed by your abilities, and then disengage when the actual timer of the Smoke Bomb is about to go. So and Cloak of Shadows actually will allow you to kind of most of the time also get the cooldown for your vanish to just to vanish from the team fight. You know what I mean? And on level 13, we did go for the elusiveness and increase the movement speed of again. People can't reveal you, so you will get more bonuses from your trait. More movement speed on your trait. Level 16, we did go for exposed armor. I think seal fate is okay, but you do lose that one combo point. Let's see, you open up with your W, which is two combo points, and then you follow up with your Q to get the more damage, the 50% additional damage, but you will lose one combo point in the process, which I don't think is optimal, right? So I just went for exposed armor, which kind of fits in with the level one, level four initiative, because you can finish your combo much quicker. You know, the first 3 point exposed armor, so you can do WWE, and then for the next 2 seconds they will be taking additional damage, so your Q will deal additional damage and your few of your basic attacks will deal that additional damage. So I do believe exposed armor is pretty okay with this build. And at level 20, we'll go for cold blood. Just gives you holy shit so much damage. We were able to delete the Haka, we were able to delete Li Ming, especially with the glass cannon, which he did go for. We were able to delete the enemy Tychus. Almost anybody. I mean, not delete the Haka, but we were able to kind of 1v1 him up to the point where he just lost the team, when he just lost the fight and he was just killed by me. But yeah, this is a standard I do go for. I did try a different one, which is what you can go for. I think I might record a different video about this one. So it's Vigor, Relentless Strikes, Mutilate, Smoke Bomb, then you go for the Blind, I believe. Yeah, I think it's the Blind. Death from Above. Or actually, might be Elusiveness still. Seal Fate, and then level 20, you do go for Cold Blood. I do believe just Cold Blood is just straight up so strong. I mean, you know, I do. It's so strong that I go for my trait, you know, basically across the entire entire skill tree. But at level 20, I don't go for the cooldown reduction. I just still go for Cold Blood. It's that strong. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave that like ring. If you haven't already, subscribed to our channel. I know this might have not been as entertaining as you guys expected, but I don't really enjoy playing, slippery heroes and heroes who are, you know, who rely on their stealth to blow up a target. She's fun to play because she does a lot of damage and she does them to the right targets. But she's just not my cup of tea. I will be playing her a little bit though. We might record another video about her coming up soon. And yeah, so hopefully you guys are as excited as I am to get that going. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.